welcome to our 2023 talent show.
We're so glad you can make it.
Please enjoy.
First up, we have Grayson Nelson in first grade playing God Bless America on the piano. We're going to tell you a couple of jokes. Why can't Elsa from Frozen have a balloon?
Okay, next. Okay. Why did the boy eat his homework? Because the teacher said it was a piece of cake.
Next up, we're going to have Quentin Evans in fourth grade singing Play It Again. Yeah.
She was sitting all alone over on the tailgate. Tamara swinging by Georgia Plate. I was looking for her boyfriend, thinking, oh, she ain't got one. Soon as I sat down, I was falling in love, trying to pour a little sugar in her Dixie cup. Talking over the speakers in the back of that truck, she jumped up and cut me off. She was like, oh my God, this is my song. I've been listening to the radio all night long, sitting around waiting for it to come on, and here it is. She was like, come here, boy, I wanna dance. Her, I said a word, she was taking my hand, spin them in her hair, and I played it out till she gave me a kiss. She said, play it again, play it again, play it again. If I said, play it again, play it again, play it again. I'd play that DJ my last time. If you were to play it just a one more time. But a little while later, we were sitting in the dive in my truck. Before I walked up through the door, I was staring like a fool. AM, FM, XM, 2. But I stopped her real quick when I heard that groove. Man, you should have seen her line up. She was like, oh my God, this is my song. We've been listening to the radio all night long. Okay.
Speakers go off. Let's do what we did back in the old days about a year ago. Let's make sure all of our phones are either off or on Bluetooth is turned off. That means if you have an Apple Watch, your Apple Watch will just have to deal without having the phone for a few minutes. So please turn off your Bluetooth or turn off your phone if you can, and that'll make our lives a little bit easier. And maybe next time I won't be using Bluetooth to do this kind of thing. We'll do some sort of direct connection.
Why did the bucket go to the doctor? It was looking a little pale.
Next we have Jude Harris in second grade telling a couple of jokes.
Jude Harris, and I will be telling jokes. What's the king of all school supplies? The ruler. Why did the boy throw the butter? Because he wanted to see a butterfly. What do you call a fake noodle?
What?
An impasta. grades did the pirate get in school? High C's. Why was the Easter Bunny so upset? Because he was having a bad hair day.
Next, we have Melanie Kilborn in eighth grade doing an Allegro flute solo.
Great. Next up, we have Ayari Lepe in fifth grade singing In the Name of Love.
This was only gonna hurt if I warned you that the fire's gonna burn. Would you let me do it first? Do it all in the name of love. Would you let me do even when you're blind in the darkness, in the middle of the night, in the silence, when there's no one by your side? Would you call in the name of love? Name of love, in the name of love, name of love. Would you trust me when you're jumping from the heights? Would you fall in the name of love? When there's madness, when there's poison in your head, when there's sadness broken in your bed, I will hold you in the depths of your despair, and it's all in the name of love, in the name of love.
Testify
screaming the holy lie. You beat me back to life, and it's all in the name of love. I wanna testify, screaming the holy lie.
Why did the coach go to the bank? To get his quarterback. Why is cold water so insecure? Because it's never called hot.
What did the two breeds say at their wedding day? It's a loaf at first sight. Next, we have London in fourth grade and Hattie in second singing Joyful, Joyful.
Joyful, joyful, it is worthy, God of glory.
play the fight song on her trumpet. Second grade telling jokes.
How do all the oceans say hello to each other? They wave. What did one wall say to the other wall? I'll meet you at the corner. What do you call a bear with no teeth? A gummy bear. Why did the math book look so sad? Because it had so many problems. What do you call cheese that isn't yours? Nacho cheese. Where do cows go for entertainment? To the movie. What do you call a pig that knows kowati? A pork chop. Why are ghosts bad liars? Because you can see right through them. Why can't you get Elsa with a balloon? Because she will let it go. Next up, we have Jonah Post in sixth grade doing a card trick.
I'm gonna call someone up. Raise your hand if you wanna do it. Barrett. This.
Doctor, I think I'm a chicken.
How long have you felt like this?
Since I was an egg.
Next we have Hank Shin in fourth grade to walk on his hands.
Next, we have Matthew and Silas Warner doing gymnastics.
Thank you.
in second grade doing ballet to Runaway.
Thank you.
What do you call a barber?
Harry.
Why did the woman quit being a dentist? She didn't have the patience for it.
Next up is Harper Wilson in fourth grade singing Holy Water.
Now we have Grady Ide and Jordy West in second grade telling jokes. Playing Thunderstorms in Summer by the piano.
Thank you.
now we will listen to Hadley Brown in second grade sing Silent Night.
Keenick playing "Oh Susanna" on the harmonica.
How did the bull play for his lunch? How did the bull pay for his lunch? He charged it.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Iowa.
Iowa who?
Iowa, a lot of lunch money to the cafeteria.
Now we will watch the eighth grade do a dance.
You guys have
Next up, we have Riley Purdom in second grade singing Tennessee Organ, Orange.
You tell daddy, he'll blow a fuse. Don't worry, I'm doing okay. I know you raised me to know right from wrong. It ain't what you think, and I still write songs. Just never thought I'd see the day. I've never felt this way.
Next, we have Carolyn Raymaker in second grade telling jokes.
Hi, my name is Carolyn Raymaker, and I have some funny jokes to tell you. Remember, if I say knock knock, don't forget to answer it if it's your class. Hey, fourth grade, how are sweet potatoes able to get so much work done? Because they aren't couch potatoes. Hey, first grade, knock, knock.
Ice cream.
Ice cream if you don't let me in.
Whoa. Hey, sixth grade, what has only one horn but gives lots of milk?
What?
A milk truck.
Hey, fifth grade, knock, knock.
Goat.
Go to.
Go to the door and find out.
Hey, preschool and kindergarten, knock, knock.
Who's there?
K. KLMNOPQRSTUVWXYZ. Hey, third grade. Why was the farm cat afraid of the trees?
Why?
Because it didn't like its bark. In middle school, how do barn cats get over a fight?
How?
They hiss and make up. Hey, second grade.
Hey,
what's the worst thing about having an ant farm? Finding a tractor small enough. And that's the end of my funny joke show.
Next up, we have Reed Steele playing Frodo's Bag on the recorder.
Not good.
wonderful song. Next up, we're going to have Reed Steele in third grade playing Photos Bag on the recorder.
Next, we have Indy Sorensen, Hayden Griffith, and Carsey Skellinger in fifth grade doing a puppet show.
Thank you. Next, we have Kinsley Knudstrom in fifth grade telling jokes.
Why don't eggs tell jokes?
Because they crack each other up.
Why do people take an extra pair of socks when they go golfing?
Why?
In case they get a hole-in-one.
No.
Have any of you guys heard about the chocolate record player?
No.
It sounds pretty sweet. How does a moon cut its hair?
How?
He eclipses it. What has more letters than the alphabet? The post office. My glasses are $200. I didn't see that one coming. How does a taco say grace? Lettuce pray. Why did the math book look so sad? Because it had all of its problems wrong. What did one hat say to the other? Stay here, I'm going on ahead. Did you hear the rumor about the butter? Well, I'm not going to spread it.
Next, we have Finn Williamson and Rebecca Levine in fourth grade doing an instrumental duet to the song Split Decision.
Next up, we have Mrs. Simmons reading a book.
Today is National Read Aloud Day, so while we're setting up the mats again, I thought I'd read you a quick story about a T-Rex who's in the talent show. It says, "We will rock our classmates." Penelope was the only T-Rex in her school, and sometimes that made her stand out a little. And sometimes Penelope's classmates didn't see her at all. They just saw a dinosaur. "Hey, you want to play cops and dinosaur? You can be the dinosaur." "Well, I was hoping to play dentist." "Great, we'll be the dentist and you can be the dinosaur." "Have you been flossing? William Amato's backpack is stuck in your teeth." Dinosaur, not Penelope, loved to play. She loved to read. "Good night, tasty moose, all wrapped in bologna. Good night, tasty goose, all side dish of pony." Ponies. And she loved to draw. "Wait, I promise I won't eat you. I don't have any mustard." But the one thing Penelope loved to do more than anything else was to make music. She loved to sing and she loved to play guitar. Penelope loved to rock and roll. So when Mrs. Noodleman told the class about the school talent show, Penelope was so excited. And she was also so nervous. She wanted to rock her classmates. But could she do it? Also, the sign-up sheet was right next to Walter, the ferocious goldfish. Penelope took a deep breath. She had to do it. She tiptoed past Walter, and she quickly wrote her name with the bravest purple marker. After school, Penelope shared the big news with her parents. "I'm going to wear a pink tutu and big boots and spikes on my scales and look angry, but I'll actually be very happy. And oh, it's going to be so great." She hummed her favorite songs while she brushed her teeth. She danced all the way to the bus. She even told her classmates about her favorite band, The Weevils. "Best band ever. My dad used to go to all the concerts until he accidentally ate the drummer." At last, it was time for the rehearsal. This is just the rehearsal. Can dinosaurs even play guitar? And on stage, Penelope froze. She could not sing. She could not play guitar. She worried that dinosaurs could not rock and roll. Penelope was very quiet on the car ride home. She hardly ate anything for supper. "Are you sure you don't want more, Penny Pie? You've only had 52 burgers." The next day at recess, Penelope sat alone on the bench. She would not play hopscotch. "I'm a T-Rex, not a hopscotcher." She would not play duck, duck, goose. "I am not a duck. I am not a duck, and I am not a goose. I am just a dinosaur." At the end of the day, Penelope crossed her name off the sign-up sheet with the saddest blue marker. When she got home, she went straight to her room. Daddy Rex came in to talk to her. "Is everything okay?" he asked. "I can't be in the talent show," she cried. "I'm just a dinosaur." "Ah, I see, Daddy Rex," said Daddy Rex. "Come with me. Take a look at our family album. This is your Uncle Frank. He was a figure skater. Oh, and here's your mom finishing up her first marathon. And here's me, the world hamburger eating champion. I ate 5,053 hamburgers with ketchup." "You see," said Daddy T-Rex, "being a T-Rex is only part of who you are. You, for instance, are kind and caring and creative and adventurous, and you can be anything you want to be." The next day at school, Penelope marched back over that sign-up sheet. She looked straight at Walter, the ferocious goldfish, and almost lost her nerve. But Penelope's classmates had a different idea. "Hey, can we play with you in your band? Please, Penelope, we want to be in your band." And that gave her just enough courage. On the night of the show, Penelope was really excited and also really nervous as she peeked out from backstage to try and find her parents. Can you see her parents? When the curtains opened, William Amato and his amazing animal sounds took the stage. Tweet, tweet, honk, honk. Mabel Haystrings and her big dancing pony went second. Tippity, tap, tap, tap. Then there was the Stegman Brothers synchronized swimming minds act. I actually think our eighth graders did that many years ago. Followed by Martina Cortez and her dazzling card tricks. Your cards, the ten of hearts, no. Was it the elephant of spades? Finally, it was Penelope's turn. The lights on the stage were bright, but not as bright as Penelope. We are Penelope and the Mustard Seeds. Penelope was a T-Rex. She was also kind, caring, and creative and adventurous. But most of all, Penelope was a rock star. Yay, Penelope! Penelope and the Mustard Seeds came in second place, just behind Mabel Haystrings and her dancing pony. That was okay with Penelope, because she loved ponies. Thank you.
Please, you have to stop making police-related puns.
Okay, I'll give it a rest.
I can't understand why my calculator stopped working. It just doesn't add up. Brandy Johnson and Nora Wagner in third grade will be dancing to Make It Super Loud.
Tumbling to Dream.
Thank you.
Jocelyn Evans and Allie Matthews in second grade dancing to Nails, Hair, Hips, and Heels.
Nails, hair, hips, heels, face, done, lips, real, purse, full, big deals. Yes, I'm a big deal. Legs, legs, face, eyes, big face, big thighs. You need, you wish, you phone, you this, that, 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 sugar, dum, dum, dum. Mommy has got in your pop that tongue. Yeah. This whole club is a runway run. Y'all pop that.
Next up, we have Genevieve Nigmeyer in fourth grade dancing to Confident.
Thank you.
What do you need to bring to music class? A notebook.
How do you catch your music teacher? With a clarinet.
Why did the baker make so much bread? Because she was needed.
What do you get when you put glue on your donut? A pastry.
Why did the horse break up with her boyfriend? He didn't seem stable.
What did the dairy farmer say to his wife? You're my butter half.
Next we have Leisha Clark, Shaylee Cohen, and Austin Johnwell, and the teachers doing a skit.
Let's give a hand to our lunch ladies and lunch men who put up with a lot of stuff.
Next up, we have Chase Butler in second grade telling jokes.
What do you call a witch's garage? A broom closet. What has one horn and flies? A garbage truck. Where do werewolves live? In a warehouse. Why did the girl eat her homework? Because the teacher told her it was a piece of cake.
So somebody donated a brand new iPhone for us, or they dropped it.
That's mine.
Who is it?
This is Hetzel.
That's yours? Thank you. We'll use it for film class.
Next we have Zeke Coke in kindergarten singing Spider-Man.
Next up, we have Zoe Wagner and Amelia Kendrick playing a flute duet. History of Ellie.
and the purple paint to make a flower. I'm going to make 3 of these flowers. Then I'm gonna be using the fourth to paint pink flowers in between the purple flowers. Then I'm gonna be using a paintbrush to be drawing the stems. I'm not gonna put them on one line. Then I'm gonna be using dark green for the grass. I'm gonna put them in between the stems, and then I'm done.
That was better than I could ever do. Next up, we'll have Kylan Allen in fifth grade singing Secret.
Did you expect me to give up and hope that you manage? Forget all the moments that you used to say felt like magic. I guess I'm hopeless because I can't let go. Sometimes I wish that I could turn to stone. Am I
say
Two faces just passing by like that, and I'm gone.
Johnson and Jonah Post doing an instrumental, Go Big Red.
Next up, we'll hear from Presley Merritt in fourth grade singing Angels Among Us.
Stranger.
Knock, knock. Sarah. Sarah, snow day tomorrow?
Why do snowmen make bad boyfriends? Because they're cold-hearted.
Why did the snowflakes go on a date? They were falling for each other.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Cashew.
Cashew.
I'll cash you later.
Why did the almond report to the principal's office? It was going nuts.
Now we have Ryder Baird and Reed Baird singing, doing the drum and guitar.
Hello, can you hear me?
Enjoyed it.
I am so impressed. You guys, as an audience, did amazing. I am so proud of all of you. And everybody has so much talent. Thank you, everybody, for sharing it with us. And thank you for coming. And we are going to let the little ones go first because they have to get ready for lunch, right? Yeah. Okay, so let's go pre-K and kindergarten.